Today's video is sponsored by Storyworth.
I still think I can get it off if I try hard enough.
The guy at the place said Clorox and a Brillo pad, and I always try to be aware if I decide that I don't like something to let y'all know. But when I heard that, I was like, oh my gosh, and I am totally flipping out. Good morning, welcome to the vlog.
Oh, is that thing on?
Time.
Can't see, yeah. Can't see.
What are you looking at?
Can't see. I'm just kidding. Another tattoo idea.
Uh-oh.
You've been into it more than I have this the second time around, but I've been dealing with other things.
Dealing with other things? What have you been dealing with?
Baby Nemos.
Oh, yeah, the baby
Nemos. We'll talk about that in a minute.
Yeah. We'll talk about all of that in a minute. We're going to give y'all a little update on our tattoos and how we're liking them, and we're kind of planning our next one already. So we'll tell you about that momentarily. Right now, we're being a little bit quiet. We've got this door shut to our bedroom back here because Brooks is homesick today. He woke up not feeling well. He doesn't have a fever, so I could have sent him, but he like could literally not hardly walk around.
You know those mornings when you're just like... Like we thought he was bluffing, mm-hmm. like playing hooky, but I was like, this ain't him.
No.
This ain't it, boss.
Like, Brooks asked for a snack or something to eat about every 10 seconds in life, and he hasn't wanted to eat, and he hasn't wanted to run around or anything. So, hopefully we don't wake him up while we're filming this, but it was time for another favorites video. It's been a minute since we've done one of these. We've been testing out some different styles with our videos and stuff, but this is really important because Mother's Day is coming up. If you didn't know, like literally this weekend, heads up.
This is crazy.
I was like, we're gonna talk about this first because if you're last minute like we are and don't have a gift, this is a perfect idea.
Perfect.
So I don't know if y'all have heard of Storyworth. I've seen it going around, and let me just be completely honest with you here. Y'all know that we take any sponsors that we do very seriously, and we actually had the opportunity to work with Storyworth back last, I think it was like last summer or something. This was during a time when we were like, we need all the money, like we're trying to just like hustle and get out of this dang house. And I looked over it and like what it was about, and I was like, I don't know, like I don't know if this would be really something we'd even use. And so I turned it down. And then like a month or so ago, I was texting with my mom about something, I don't even remember what, and we got into a conversation and started talking about like something that from her childhood and what a certain situation was like and some different members of the family. And I was like, oh my gosh, I didn't even know that your dad had a brother. And there was just some different stuff.
I was on that group text too. I was like, really?
Like it was, we were going back and forth. I was like, what are y'all even talking about? And I was like, this is so interesting to me. Like, I just want to sit down and like hear all this stuff. Cause you know, you think you know everything about your parents, and not that you know everything, but you're like, yeah, I've heard all their stories. Like I know them all. But there's so much I feel like we don't know and wouldn't know to ask. And so when Storyworth came back and asked us again, like, did we want to work together? I was like, yes, absolutely. Because I just didn't even realize the value of it before and how important it was to get the stories that you wouldn't think to ask.
Well, what is Storyworth?
So if you're not familiar, it is a very personal, sentimental, thought-provoking gift that you can share with your mom, your grandmother, whoever. It doesn't have to be a mom, but it happens to be Mother's Day this weekend. And so this is an excellent option. Excuse our cat. Sorry, we're still trying to figure out this new camera. It keeps flickering. I'm like, stop flickering. We got the stabilization figured out, but now it's flickering. Okay, what Storyworth does is you sign up and it will send whoever you want to do this project a email every week with a thought-provoking question. Like, for example, one of them was like, when did you get your first car? Or how did you get your first car? Tell me about your first job. What was some of the best advice that your mother gave you? Or what are some talents that you have that, you know, you don't utilize but you used to, or whatever?
I feel like some of them, like you said, are thought-provoking. So they'll start off, you know, parents, especially all the wisdom that they have. And I know this is for Mother's Day, but Dad would have loved this because he was always wanting even y'all to send emails back in the day.
Oh, yeah.
Remember that?
Yeah,
so
yeah,
like,
yeah.
Tell his wisdom and tell stories.
Yeah.
So I wish this was around whenever he was, or I wish I'd have known about it whenever he was still around.
Yeah. Because I'm sure you get some more information than even the stories that he would always like tell over and over again.
Right.
But there's probably some stuff that he didn't tell over and over again. Like my mom was telling me how one of her cousins used to like drive up on his motorcycle and like come pick up her brother. And I was like, what the heck? I never knew about any of this. Like that's just, it's so cool to get to hear. And I know 2020 into 2021 has been a little crazy. A lot of us, especially us because we moved, but the average person has seen their family less than other people. So you may have had less opportunity to exchange stories.
So at the end of a full year, it puts all the stories into a book and they can upload pictures and everything. It's a great little keepsake. And we could show it to our kids and be like, listen to how your grandmother was back in the day.
And you can order as many books as you want. So, like, say that you get your mom to do this and you, like, gift it to her for Mother's Day. You can order books for all your siblings or whoever else you think might want to have them.
And so. It ships free. If y'all are interested, be sure to check it out at storyworth.com/Cullen and Katie. Plus, right now, you get $10 off and literally get an email sent to them right now. Like, as soon as you sign up. Yes. So there, Mother's Day's
Happy
done.
Happy Mother's Day. There
Happy
you go.
Happy Mother's Day.
Storyworth.com/Cullen and Katie, and you'll get $10 off.
If y'all see it, well, it kind of looks okay outside.
Yeah, it looks okay, but it's been storming like crazy. I actually had somebody message me about this the other day on Instagram, and I was glad to share. If y'all aren't familiar, this is kind of random. You don't live in, like, tornado or weather places, but a weather radio is incredibly important this time of year with, like, tornado season coming up. This is a weather radio, if you're not familiar. So right now it is actually flashing because we currently have a flash flood, not tornado warning, we would not be making this video, a flash flood warning in effect in our area. And so you can have it plugged into the wall or it has batteries. And then on the side, there's this little switch that says to switch on the weather radio. So what this will do is it will go off with a really annoying loud sound if there is a tornado warning in your area.
And your sound asleep.
And you're sound asleep. Now, one thing that I was like, well, we don't need that because we have notifications on our phone, but I keep my phone on Do Not Disturb at night, and I keep it on silent. And there are some nights when we know bad weather's coming and I'll keep my phone, like, turned up, but there's sometimes that these things happen in the middle of the night and you have no idea. One of the reasons I didn't want one of these is because I know they go off for every single, like, weather event, and I do not need this thing going off all hours of the night. But I realized you can set it, like, right now it's flashing, but I have it set, like, I don't need to know about a flash flood in the middle of the night, but I have it set just for tornado warnings to go off in the middle of the night. It'll wake you up so you can get to your safe place. If you live in an area where there is bad storms, tornadoes, they even have, like, for other areas, they have, like, tsunami warnings and, like, avalanche warnings and blizzard warnings and all kinds
That's
of
crazy.
Stuff. So I think you can get them at, like, Walmart for $30
They're
or something.
They're pretty old school. Brooks was even like, what's that long thing sticking up?
It's got, like, an actual antenna. But another cool thing is if you just push it, like, I don't want to do it right now because I don't know how loud it'll be with that warning, you can get the current weather for your area. And, like, for us, it'll tell, like, the current Gulf Coast water temperatures and all that stuff. So that's pretty cool. In keeping with the spring and summer season, y'all know we've talked about our bug zapper that we have in the backyard. I'll leave a link to that too because that's definitely been a favorite and deserves a place in the favorites video. Another thing with summer coming up. If you've never seen our summer merch, this is our summer merch.
You're wearing some.
I am wearing some. So we've had this actually for, I think this is the second, maybe third summer with it. I personally love, like, their heathered shirts. The material is very, very soft, but we have summer vibes. That's the Summer Vibes beach towel. Like, how cute is that? The kids love these. Brooks has an orange one. Gaines has a purple one. The purple one is actually the vacay mode, right?
Yeah.
Let's see. Show the vacay mode right quick.
Summer Vibes vacay mode.
Go stand over there. Model for us. This is the vacay mode one. And I think they're so cute. We totally designed them ourselves. And then the folks at Teespring helped us get them on a shirt. That's the vacay mode. This is the Summer Vibes tank top. If you are a tank top person, these are the softest, most comfortable. They're flowy tank tops, which I like. They're not fitted. They do run a tad small, so you might want to size up in it. Super thin and flowy. And then the back of them has the, what you call that?
Scrunch wrap supreme.
Sure. We will leave a link for those below. We have shirts. We actually have a pillow. We should have gotten the pillow out. So, like, when it's summer, we'll put a little pillow on our couch.
Hey, that would make a good tattoo.
Oh, that's kind of like that one that I put in.
Yeah. Speaking of tattoos.
Speaking of tattoos. Nice segue there, Johnny. So, do we regret getting our tattoos now here a week later?
Gosh. I still think I can get it off if I try hard enough.
The guy at the place said Clorox and a Brillo pad. You can get it off. You want to?
Did he really? I missed that.
Oh, you missed that? Yeah. He was making a joke, and he was like, I really need to quit saying that because people, somebody's going to go home and do it when their mom gets mad they got a tattoo.
No, I do not regret it.
No, I don't either at all. I love it. I think it's wonderful, and, well, it kind of looks funky when I turn my arm a certain way, but they're starting to peel a little bit. We'll see how yours is doing. Let's get the peeling. So if you've never had a tattoo, this is what they do as they heal. You can kind of see like the skin starting to peel up a little bit around the edges. Doing well. We've kept it moisturized with some lotion.
I don't know if I was supposed to sweat as much as I did yesterday, and it kind of made me nervous.
A couple days, it's okay, but it was like light around the edges after you got finished. But I think the thing is, it's not going to come off. It would just affect the quality of the ink, which obviously you can get touched up. We are loving our tattoos. We are planning our next tattoos already. I have a reason for that, particularly because my original tattoo design that I was going to do, I decided it wouldn't really actually work well on my wrist. And so I was like, well, I really know I still want it, even though I want this text. So I'm in the process of designing my next one. I shouldn't say I got him thinking about it, but once I started talking about my next one, he was like, let me see what I want to do. So he started looking up ideas for his, and we'll kind of share the process with y'all. So stay tuned. If you missed our whole tattoo saga, you can go watch that video.
We'll actually talk about what we're getting next video. Probably.
Yeah.
Show y'all.
Yeah, we'll talk about it and show you. I've actually got a little design there. I'm trying to decide between my arm right there or on my foot. We'll see. In line with tattoos, another major favorite for me has been my eyebrows. I think it's like day 21. It's been a long time. I feel like my face is greasy, so pardon that. I don't know how much you can actually see, but I do have a little bit of like powder to fill in spots, but they look pretty amazing. The skin has finally peeled off. You're taking away my focus.
Sorry.
Your eyebrows look great too, babe.
Thanks.
The skin has finally like peeled off its little layer that it's supposed to, and the color actually will go away a little bit at first, and so it's in the process of coming back, but I'm loving them. If you've ever considered microblading, it is a bit expensive. It was gifted to me as a birthday gift from my parents, because I was like, I really wanted to do this, but I just, you know, hadn't wanted to spend the money on myself, and so it's a great thing to ask for a gift if you would like, but I highly recommend it. It is a little bit painful. It's totally worth it for the fact they're going to last for like 2 years, maybe, something like that.
Johnny.
Oh, the other thing I was gonna say about tattoos, if you've been ever in your life considering getting a tattoo and you just keep putting it off, first of all, you never know how many days you have left on this earth, so why wait? Second of all, I highly recommend drawing it on yourself in the places that you think you might want it, trying out different designs. That has been incredibly helpful for us. Like, had I just gotten what I was like, oh, I love this design, it looks so good, and had I just gotten it where I wanted it, it wouldn't have worked out. Like, I wouldn't have ended up liking it. Because
it
once
it looked like a psychology ink blot test, like it did on my stories the other
That one. I'm talking about the very first one that I was going to do on my wrist. But once I had it on there and like walked around for a day or two with it in a certain place, like I just drew it on with a Sharpie. I don't know, it was good. But there is a place we haven't actually used because we went about the process pretty quickly. Inkbox.com, where you can go and like put in your design and they'll send you a temporary tattoo that'll stay on for like 1 to 2 weeks.
I might want to try that with my next one, because my next one, I just want to try.
And you're not going to be able to draw your next one yourself,
right?
Like to test it out. Yeah. So
I might go with some color on my next one.
That's a good idea. Yeah, let's do that. Yeah. Get you an Inkbox.
Will Inkbox do color?
I don't know if they will or not. We'll have to look into that. So we haven't even tried it. Somebody just mentioned it to us. Okay, we've mentioned this before, but it totally deserves a place in the mention of the summer stuff is the water blob, which right now our yard looks like its own river water blob. But if y'all aren't familiar with this, maybe Colin could put in some footage of the kids using it on a nice sunny day.
I saw one the other day. Where were we?
At Target with Jared.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Everybody knows Jared is here.
I was like, you said, I was like, oh, sorry.
No, it was Walmart, but it was a water blob.
Made by the same people, H2O
slip and
Go.
Slide with a little pool at the end, but it was a water blob.
And so it was like,
it's crazy.
Yeah, because our kids do the slip and slide thing, but then they just go off the end. We have loved that thing. This has been our fourth summer having one. I think we first got one when Gaines was two. They right now have them, or they had them at our Sam's Club for
$30.
No, $19.99. And they sell them at Target for $29.99. $30.
After you get done on the water blob, you need to be hydrated. And we've also talked about this on our stories, but this is a freaking favorite. I literally drink this every single day. Hydration Multiplier by Liquid IV. The pear flavor is their newest flavor.
Yes.
And they always send cute little package stuff.
You can actually get those in one of the little packages on their website.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So if you want to order some, I know we've talked about Liquid IV before, so we won't spend much time on it, but the new flavor absolutely deserved a mention because it's freaking amazing. Even Gaines tasted it and was like, oh, this is good. Okay, this next one is kind of a non-recommendation. This is something I've recommended in the past, and I always try to be aware if I decide that I don't like something to let y'all know. If y'all have this blow dryer, Let me just tell you, this is the most amazing blow dryer ever, and it makes my hair voluminous and blow dries quicker, and I don't have to straighten it as much. But I saw a girl on an Instagram story make a story about how she had heard several people mention their hair having breakage due to using this hair dryer, and she literally like threw hers in the trash can. I haven't thrown mine away, but when I heard that, I was like, oh my gosh, because if y'all know, I've always talked about how I have issues with my front hair growing. It literally never grows past my chin because it always breaks off. It's the longest it's ever been. It's like literally almost the same length as the rest of my hair finally. It's actually, like it's always grown, but it always breaks off.
Is it due to the heat?
And so, well, she was talking about, she was like, I don't know, because I've even talked to my hairstylist about this. Like I've been using a blow dryer like this, of this sort of style since high school. My stylist was always like, well, I mean, it's just like using a brush on your hair. The thing is, the heat is coming like directly out of the brush. So when you're here, when you're using a regular blow dryer, you're using a brush and you're like brushing and blow drying like right here, you know? And so as you brush, you can kind of like brush and then you're blow drying. You're not like heat. Like every bit of brushing you do is not heat. And then you flat iron it. It also tugs on your hair a lot when it's wet, which I do that with a round brush anyway. It has definitely made a difference. And I am totally flipping out. So if you have this and you've had issue with hair breakage, the girl that I was watching was having breakage issues like back in the back because that's where she blew dry the most. And I guess I do a lot in the front. I've held on to it because I do use it for styling, which isn't drying from totally wet second day hair or whatever. I'll just like quickly run it through to kind of fluff it up.
Let me get you a paper towel to wipe all the hair off of here.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. The next thing on our list. We went to a friend's house. Y'all remember we talked about we went and hung out with these friends and we totally decided to redo our kids' bedrooms. Well, we also decided to get a new paper towel holder.
Look at this.
So we prefer to keep them under the cabinet because I just don't like them up here on the island and we've had them down there. Look, it hangs on the door and you have a place for your rag, which we always hang it on here.
Typically been feeding it through that and that just drives me crazy.
Because then I have to flip it up if I want to open these.
And we're taking up space in here for like trash bags and everything else. We had a whole holder right here. But now it's 2-in-1 right there over the edge. It was off of Amazon.
And it's got like
$12.
The soft thing so it doesn't hurt your door. And in true Cullen and Katie fashion, Cullen like looked up multiple others to make sure. And he was like, this is actually the best one. And so he got this one. So leave you a link for that. We'll leave you a link for all the things except the blow dryer. Oh, if they're wondering what blow dryer I've actually been using, I just went to Walmart and like stood there and searched like, is this one good? Is this one good?
Yeah, really?
And I don't know. I'll leave you a link to the one I ended up getting. It's some Conair something. It was the middle of the road. I wasn't going to pay like $100 for blow dryer, but I also didn't want to pay $20.
I came home with this stuff the other day. You wanted some simple green, just the green kind to
do Brooks's baseball pants.
Yeah, his pants clean.
Because they'd remove stains.
And I found that as well as the green kind, and that has been my favorite.
It smells so good.
I just wiped out my whole car yesterday.
I was going to say, I would say this is definitely one of your favorites because you love things to smell good.
Yes.
And once we got it, I started wiping the counters with it because I just loved how much it smelled. Y'all know I've talked about this before. I always like to give you an update on if I'm still liking something because it was the first time I tried it. This is the Granite Gold Daily like granite cleaner for the countertops. I started using this and I was like, well, it works just as good. But over time, I was missing this so much because I just feel like granite's just weird. It just didn't get everything off. It kind of left a film. It just wasn't, I don't know. It just wasn't right.
Some granite
cleaner. I love some granite cleaner. So this is still my top recommendation for a granite cleaner.
Okay. How you doing over there?
I'm just checking on the fishies.
Don't have any legs. I was going to talk about those, but I'll just save that for my stories. You'll go check out my Instagram stories.
We have babies.
We have, I think, as of recording this video, only one, I think, right now.
But 6 of them hatched, and 6 little baby Nemos have been swimming around in the tank for several days.
5 days now. They metamorphosize, and after they get through meta, then you can start feeding them dry food, and then they start really growing a lot faster.
Speaking of metamorphosizing.
What's morphosizing?
What's your other favorite that has a morph in the name?
Oh, good segue, Johnny.
Thank you.
When I got my vasectomy, I happened to find these. in the store. You haven't tried Now and Later's Morphs. It's like two flavors combined, and they're like soft chew. You like them too, don't you?
I do. Sorry, I just realized the April lunch menu has now expired because it's May. But yeah, they're really good because they're like a little bit soft. I actually ended up getting the girl in the Dollar General to buy them because I was like, my husband wants four bags of these. She's like, really, they're that good? I was like, they're really that good. And she said, hang on, let me find some of these for me.
Anytime I go to Dollar General, I have to look for this stash. As of recording this too right now, it is Cinco de Mayo.
Now we can celebrate appropriately.
Happy Cinco de Mayo. That does it for now. That was it. Y'all go check out, I got this towel still on my head. I'll be sure to check out all the links below. Check out Storyworth for the best Mother's Day gift right now, right there.
If y'all have any products that you would like us to review or any other links that we mentioned before that you want, leave them in the comments. We have comments now so you can comment about it.
Woo!
There you go. Don't forget to be confident.
Stay kind.
And we will see you in the next video.
Create yourself and trust yourself. Bye!